Morning, everyone. My name is James Dufresne, and I would like to thank Reverend Pastana for inviting me to speak to you today. It's an honor and a privilege to be here as part of our recognition of Earth Day and to speak to you about what Earth Day means to me and how it relates to us. First, a little about me and how I ended up here before you this morning. Like many of us, whether you're talking about sports teams or politics, I've always had a soft spot for underdogs and an imagination of the possibilities their victories could bring. So naturally for me, about 18 months ago, I was looking at the Bernie Sanders for President website and decided to click the events link. I was excited to see that there were standouts for Bernie as close as Bridgewater on a monthly basis. So I ordered my bumper stickers, my signs, and a t-shirt two sizes too small. And proudly took up my post on the Bridgewater Green doing my part, feeling the burn. I had some good times and met some great people at these standouts. But a 10-year-old boy named Raymond is the one I want to talk to you about today. See, Raymond and his mother drove all the way up from Mashpee to be part of the standout last February. When I talked to Raymond and listened to the enthusiasm and excitement in his voice and his desire to help the world, it reminded me of myself at his age. Later that Saturday, caught up in my rediscovered energy to change and save the world, I did what I don't normally do, is I signed an online petition to tell Governor Baker to take a stand against fracking and more gas pipelines in Massachusetts. So, as it turns out, that petition was set up by 350 Mass. And I was soon contacted about starting a local chapter, or NODE as they like to call it, on the South Coast. Let me pause for a second and tell you a little bit about 350 Mass and what it is. 350 Mass for a Better Future is a statewide grassroots network of volunteer members across the Commonwealth who are concerned about the impacts of climate change and are advocating for a fast and fair transition to 100% renewable energy in Massachusetts. But more about that later. So needless to say, last March, my brother John and I decided to help form the South Coast NODE. One of the first volunteer acts as a member of 350 South Coast that John and I took part in was the 26th annual citywide Earth Day cleanup in Taunton, which, interestingly enough, in true Taunton fashion, so I'm told, doesn't actually happen on Earth. But on the last Saturday in April. So a quick public service announcement, the 27th annual citywide Earth Day cleanup coordinated by the Taunton Ecological Awareness Movement is next Saturday, April 29th, for those of you looking for a simple but important way to give back to the community. So from our first NODE meeting in an apartment on Main Street in Fall River, to a couple of months of meeting at the UMass Dartmouth Library, and finally, to meeting at our sister's house in Lakeville, we knew for the group to grow and succeed, we needed a permanent spot. Each of us were asked to look for a possible meeting spot in our own communities, and with Taunton being mine, I called First Parish Church. After one conversation with Reverend Pastana, and listening to several of her sermons on podcasts, which is awesome, starting with her Creation Earth Day sermon from last year, I personally knew I had found much more than a place to meet. So last fall, we began meeting here in Elizabeth Hall on the first and third Tuesday night of the month. Shameless plug, sorry. And since then, we've played a significant role in the 350 Mass campaign selection process, including advocating for and ultimately getting a community-based push for clean, renewable energy like solar and wind. We also hosted a conversation on climate event with Senator Pacheco, where we learned about his history with the issue, his instrumental role in helping to pass the Global Warming Solutions Act of 2008, and pick his brain on some ideas on what we can do to help. At the same time, I began to attend services here on Sundays, on a regular basis, and am working on becoming a contributing member of the church. As many of you know, April 22nd is Earth Day. Earth Day is an annual event to demonstrate support for environmental protection celebrated in more than 193 countries. On Earth Day 2016, 1 year ago yesterday, the landmark Paris Agreement was signed by the United States, China, and 120 other countries. What was significant was the major countries in the world finally agreed on the impacts of climate change, the role human activity played in it, and a collective effort needed to deal with this crisis. Kofi Annan, former Secretary General of the United Nations and a recipient of the Nobel Peace Prize, said, "Let us be good stewards of the earth we inherited. All of us have to share the earth's fragile ecosystems and precious resources. And each of us has a role to play in preserving them. If we are going to on living together on this earth, we must all be responsible for it." So, paraphrasing for emphasis, each of us has a role and a responsibility in protecting the beautiful and majestic but fragile ecosystems and precious resources of the earth we inherited for future generations. Which to me relates directly to the seventh of our principles, respect for the interdependent web of all existence of which we are a part. Every day needs to be Earth Day, it's that important. "We resist, we build, and we rise" is the slogan of the People's Climate March taking place next Saturday in Washington, D.C., with many sister marches around the world. Resistance plays a necessary but ultimately small part in this, and so we will march on Washington next Saturday to show the administration and the world we are ready to accept our responsibilities as good stewards of the earth. Ultimately, though, I believe the key is we build and we rise. Ultimately, I believe it's creation, it's love. As Martin Luther King Jr. said, "Darkness cannot drive out darkness, only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate, only love can do that." In tying this all together, I refer back to our mission statement. In living our faith, we inspire spiritual growth, connect with one another, and serve the larger community in love. Thinking globally and acting locally means addressing climate change by using grassroots movements and community organizations to make a difference in the local community. Some of the things that Arno is working on in our community currently is working with local communities all throughout the South Coast on a fair and fast transition to 100% renewable energy. Working with TMLP on community solar for those that can't host it on their roof or a renter like myself. And developing an energy efficiency program for the community at large. Working on possibly getting solar on the church.
I'm not dismaying, just overwhelming.
Okay. Working on the Taunton River Trail to enhance our open space in Taunton and hopefully develop something for kayaking, biking, multimodal for Taunton to appreciate and take pride in. The Team Earth Day cleanup, which we will have an alternate date available for people to participate in if Saturday's not available to you. Next Saturday's not available to you. Other things we can do in our community, obviously reuse, reduce, recycle. Community supported agriculture, community gardens, farmers markets, bike sharing, carpooling, LED bulbs, etc., etc., etc. There's plenty of them. Ultimately, we need to be the change we'd like to see in the world. We need to take everything we can accomplish as individuals and amplify them through collective action, of our connected community. As the banner on the side of this church says, be the church, protect the environment, fight for the powerless, share earthly and spiritual resources, forgive often, embrace diversity, love God, and enjoy life. I leave you today with these words credited to the Persian poet Hafez. Even after all this time, the sun never says to the earth, you owe me. Look what happens with a love like that. It lights the whole sky. Thank you.